Hello, everybody. Mr. Gilbert here, and we're going to jump into a little bit of EMS Target 1, focusing on 1A and 1B. So in your journal, kind of define, copy these things. We're going to go over it a little bit here. This we're going to do a little, 3 and 4, and we're going to touch on 5, 6, and 7, but that will primarily be a different video. So, of course, the reason for the seasons, because we have seasons, we want to explain how and why we get uneven amounts of energy from the sun. This will be a key in class, so I'll do a little demo. Mr. Kempton will do a little demo. But the main reasons are we get uneven amounts of energy from the sun as we go around it in our year. That is because of the tilt. You know, we are tilted about 23.5 degrees. We're at a constant tilt. We don't change. Our position and tilt towards the sun is the same year-round. That's why we get varying amounts of daylight or sunlight during the year. The rotation. What the heck is rotation? That's one of our vocab words. And how does it give us seasons? Well, it also gives us day and night, which is pretty important. And revolution, of course, giving us our year. How does that give us the season? What would happen if we didn't revolve around the sun? And we're going to define equinox and solstice later in the video. So, of course, in any given moment throughout the year, which area has the most direct or intense sunlight? Well, the most direct sunlight is wherever it's shining down on the Earth at a 90-degree angle. This happens to be in between the tropics throughout the year. Twice a year, the sun is directly above the equator. Of course, those are our first day of fall and first day of spring, also known as the equinox. As you get further away from the tropics towards the poles, we get very, very, very different amounts of sunlight during the year. Part of the year, they get 24 hours of sunlight. Other parts of the year, they get 0 hours because the angle compared to the sun is very low. Here's something amazing. Here's the sunset line, nighttime, daytime. Why does it curve? It's not necessarily curved because the Earth is, because if you look here, this is the sunrise line between day and night. It's a lot more straight. It's curved because, of course, of our angle. And I got three great links you can check out. This video is actually awesome. This one I absolutely love. When you go to this one, it's going to show you exactly today what part is day, what part is night with a satellite picture. It's awesome. This video is choice as well. They do a really good job on both of those, which is awesome. So, of course, the tilt of the Earth makes the angle of the sun seem to be different during the year. For us, winter, the sun doesn't get very, quote, high in the sky. We're at a low angle. We're not close to 90 degrees. Okay. As it's into summer, we have a closer to 90 degree angle of sunlight. That's why the sunlight's up in the sky a lot longer, etc. A few things you want to be able to do. Can you draw an Earth day without using time? Can you say what it is? Yeah, we know a day is about 24 hours, but what an Earth day is, an Earth year. Stop it, pause it, think if you can do some of these things. We're going to learn them in class. Hopefully, you know that a day is one rotation around itself. Here's my drawing, one spin around our own axis. Here's a little GIF showing days. A year, one revolution around the sun. If you watch this, you can see the Earth going around the sun. What's great about this one is the red line is the polar line, so it's dividing. It's always at the same angle as it goes around the sun. And of course, the start of our seasons, the equinox, equal night and day. Solstice for us in summer, our longest amount of sunshine. Equinox again. And solstice, why do we have these? Because of the tilt of the Earth and uneven amounts of sunlight. What are the reasons for the seasons? A review, you should be able to pull this one off. Of course, it's tilt, revolution, rotation. I know I said them backwards. And what are the reasons for them? Think about it because it is really important. What's going on there and why? Okay. What does it give us and why? And our revolution, we're going around the sun. What does that give us and why? And then things we're going to get to in class when we do target two is about orbit and gravity. We'll be able to answer these questions as well. So a little couple nuggets to leave you with. Remember, the tilt of the axis does not change as we go around the sun in human lifetime. And to prove this, this little dot right there is the North Star in a time-lapse photography. As you can see, the stars seeming to cruise around in a circle. That's because we're actually spinning underneath them as we rotate through our daily time. May you have a great night. Oh, if you want some awesome vocab words, it's a good way to end it. And always enjoy. Be good to yourself. Bye-bye.